In this video, we will show you how to save configuration files and carry out firmware updates with FL Network Manager. For demonstration purposes, we have set up a test network consisting of three managed switches. The switches are in their factory default state and do not have IP parameters yet. The test network is connected to the laptop. The project tree is shown at the left. All existing devices are shown here. To the right in the component area, you will find the device profiles. The login window shows you all the activities in the network and the software. In the center, there is a TFTP server, which you need in order to read devices and for firmware updates. A BOOTP DHCP server is also available to you. The middle window provides you with an overview of the project. You can also make your basic configurations here. In order to use the BOOTP server, it must first be configured under Extras, then Options in the BOOTP DHCP server tab. Select the network adapter to which your network is connected. The subnet mask is automatically accepted by the network card and can be adjusted if necessary. Alternatively, a default gateway can be assigned. You do not need a default gateway for our test network. If you want to configure a DHCP network, you can also set the IP address area and the lease time. Since the switches are set to their default status on BOOTP, we select the operating mode BOOTP. Start the server by simply clicking on Play. The requests entered in the BOOTP server are added to the reservation list via the shortcut menu. This list assigns IP parameters to the switches from the test network, depending on the current MAC address. Every assignment is sent directly to the respective device. The BOOTP DHCP server window shows you the parameter assignment. Once the parameters have been assigned, the network can be scanned. For this purpose, the Scan Options menu offers three different possibilities. The DCP scan is used to scan from Profinet networks. The SNMP scan is suitable for standard TCP/IP networks. Since all devices are already provided with an IP address in our test network, we use the ping scan here. A scanning range is entered for this. We deactivate the DCP and SNMP scan at this point. The network scan is then started via the radar button in the project overview. The result is shown on the overview page. Here there is an online area which displays the device name, serial number, and current firmware status, in addition to the IP parameters. To accept the located device into the project, all devices are marked and accepted into the project tree via Add to Project. We will present the configuration options of the FL Network Manager in another tutorial.